In the depths of space, 360 miles above Earth's surface, a constellation of European satellites is about to fundamentally cement how much power NATO can hold over Russia. What started as a modest research project in 2021 evolved into one of the most sophisticated missile warning systems ever conceived, and it's all based on rendering Russia's nuclear war intimidation tactics obsolete. This is ODIN’S EYE, Europe's answer to American space dominance and Russian missile threats, and it promises to finally give the continent something it has never truly possessed – complete autonomy over its own missile defense. So let's dive into how ODIN’S EYE works, what makes it revolutionary, and why Russia should be very, very worried. For the first time since the Cold War began, Europe will have the capability to detect and track every single ballistic and hypersonic missile launch from Russian territory within seconds. Previously, this could only have been accomplished by relying on American intelligence through NATO's data-sharing agreements, coupled with extensive infrastructure that the US built to protect its own borders first and foremost. However, that strategy ultimately depends on too many pieces, and increased fragmentation inside NATO between the US and the other members can put it in jeopardy. Instead, the ODIN’S EYE system is meant to completely cover Europe with natively developed and integrated monitoring systems. And the timing couldn't be more critical. As Putin continues to threaten nuclear escalation and deploys tactical nuclear weapons to Belarus, Europe has continued to support Ukraine and develop independent countermeasures that could be deployed in the worst-case scenario. The result is likely the most significant advancement in European space-based defense in decades, pushing the EU to the forefront of geopolitics once more. While the name ODIN’S EYE stems from mythology, specifically the all-seeing Norse god who traded his eye for wisdom, but the name of the system is Multinational Development Initiative for a Space-Based Missile Early Warning Architecture, which is a bit wordy and unevocative of the scale, complexity, and ultimately the purpose of the project. Just as Odin sacrificed his eye, the system represents Europe's willingness to invest everything in gaining complete situational awareness of the battlefield above on its own. The system relies on a group of satellites, or more technically called a constellation, flying in a low orbit around the Earth. These satellites would come equipped with advanced infrared sensors specifically designed to detect and track ballistic and hypersonic missile launches, similar to the US Resilient Missile Warning and Tracking, or RMWT, program. The system evolved from a €7.5 million initial study in 2021, approximately $8.7 million, to a €90 million development program, approximately $105 million, involving 43 companies from 14 European countries. What makes ODIN’S EYE impressive is its purported technical specifications. The satellites are designed to detect and track ballistic, hypersonic, and anti-satellite weapons, namely by detecting their heat signatures as the first suborbital stage fires up to take the missile to its intended orbit. The satellites, being located relatively close to Europe and Russia, will allow them to capture launches and broadcast warnings within seconds. But the system doesn't just care about seeing the missiles launch. It's reportedly able to track or predict their trajectories, propose potential payload characteristics, and calculate the most likely targets so that complementary defense or counterstrike sequences can be engaged in time. The infrared sensor technology represents a significant leap forward from previous European space capabilities. Europe has previously operated atmospheric monitoring satellites like the Swedish ODIN satellite since 2001, but ODIN wasn't a military satellite, and its focus on aeronomy meant that its instruments were tuned to the higher Earth atmosphere. At that point, a ballistic missile will be well on its way to a target, making a potential defense or counterstrike option too late to matter. ODIN’S EYE is the continent's first dedicated military space surveillance constellation, designed for missile defense and deterrence. Then there's the actual significance of using a space-bound system for missile detection. Unlike ground-based radar systems that can be jammed, destroyed, or limited by Earth's curvature, satellite infrared sensors provide continuous global coverage, allowing them to provide much more information and disseminate it rapidly. Plus, with the constellation setup, individual satellites can track missile signatures from boost phase through mid-course flight. This allows the system to triangulate their location, but also pinpoint their velocity and heading, allowing it to predict possible targets which can direct countermeasures or counter-strikes. The ODIN’S EYE constellation will reportedly function similarly to the US RMWT program, but with one crucial difference. It will be entirely European-controlled. The independence from the US is a vital part of the system's structure, but its technical components and effectiveness can be inferred from its American counterpart. The US RMWT program itself is a part of the American broader missile defense architecture, relying on a network of satellites in various orbits to provide continuous global coverage. The satellites use infrared sensors to detect heat signatures of missile launches, which then feed that data to ground-based interceptors and provide early warning to military commanders worldwide. Coupled with the US having several radar antennas spanning the North American continent and Europe, it provides extensive tracking of missile launches and inbound ballistic missiles across the Northern Hemisphere. The US bolsters its early warning system with one of the world's most extensive nuclear deterrence systems in the world, due to having nuclear warheads carried in missiles, submarines, and aircraft. Technically speaking, the US system is designed for broader world coverage, but the ground system, called Solid State Phased Array Radar System, or SPARS, only covers the coast of North America, Europe, and Siberia, leaving swathes of the rest of the Earth tracked only via satellite detection. This could lead to a loss of focus, as the US is potentially responsible for detecting launches anywhere in the world. The ODIN’S EYE system is more localized in nature and intent. The European constellation is specifically optimized for threats facing the European continent. If the technology behind the system is the same, this could imply slightly increased resolution and tracking capabilities for the exact flight paths that Russian missiles would take when targeting European cities, especially given that some of them could likely be launched from Belarus and Kaliningrad. The technical, or more importantly, monetary specifications reveal just how ambitious and important this type of project is. ODIN’S EYE 2, the current iteration that is the actual early warning missile system, will reportedly cost over 96.6 million euros, $113 million, and last for 36 months to implement fully, involving a consortium of 57 entities and 43 European countries working on studies and design for a space-based missile early warning system. The projected date for the system's start time is somewhere in mid-2027, at which point NATO's eastern flank in Europe should be completely covered by the newly launched satellite constellation. The consortium behind the program includes European defense giants like Thales Alenia Space, Ariane Group, Leonardo, and Airbus, which combine to make essentially the entire European space industry. This multinational approach also provides redundancy and resilience that single-nation systems cannot match. If Russia were to target specific European space assets, either via direct action or through cyberattacks, the distributed nature of ODIN’S EYE would mean that it would need to redouble its efforts to the point where they would become easily visible and respond in kind. Of course, ODIN’S EYE 2 is Europe's eye in the sky for missiles. In some way, the US had the advantage of using land radars to improve detection speed and reach, but Europe is catching up quickly with other initiatives to complement the eye. In late August 2025, Germany and France formalized an agreement to jointly develop a new missile early warning system called Joule, which improves on the ODIN’S EYE satellite constellation by adding ground-based radar facing Russia. This agreement is the most ambitious Franco-German defense collaboration since the failed attempts at joint fighter and tank development programs. The ground-based component will include large-scale radar installations capable of detecting ballistic missile launches at ranges of several thousand kilometers. These radars will work in concert with the space-based sensors to provide layered coverage and cross-verification of missile tracks. When the ODIN’S EYE satellites detect a missile launch signature, ground-based radars will immediately orient to provide precise tracking data and trajectory calculations. This hybrid approach addresses the limitations of each system. Space-based sensors excel at initial detection and broad area surveillance but can struggle with precise trajectory prediction in the terminal phase. Ground-based radars provide exceptional accuracy but have limited range and can be defeated by terrain masking. Together, the integrated sensor network can provide both early warning and precision tracking from launch to impact. The system will also serve as a pillar of the French-led TWISTER, which stands for Timely Warning and Interception with Space-Based Theater Surveillance project, which aims to augment early warning networks with a hypersonic interceptor. This integration means ODIN’S EYE has basically become the sensor backbone for an entire European missile defense architecture that could eventually include advanced interceptors capable of defeating Russian hypersonic weapons. The satellites that make up the second iteration of ODIN’S EYE are considered to far outmatch anything Russia currently possesses or can realistically develop in the coming decades. While Russia operates the Voronezh radar series for ballistic missile early warning, these ground-based systems are vulnerable to electronic warfare, physical attack, and geographical limitations. Europe's satellite system specifically seeks to detect and track ballistic, hypersonic, and anti-satellite weapons, meaning it's designed to counter Russia's most advanced missile systems, including the Kinzhal hypersonic missile, Sarmat ICBM, and any anti-satellite weapons Russia might deploy against European assets. The infrared sensor technology operates by detecting the heat signatures produced during the missile boost phase, when rocket engines are burning at maximum intensity. These signatures are virtually impossible to mask or spoof, providing reliable detection even against Russia's most advanced stealth technologies. Unlike radar-based systems that can be defeated by chaff, jammers, or stealth coatings, infrared detection relies on fundamental physics of rocket propulsion. What makes this particularly devastating for Russia is the timing advantage. Space-based infrared sensors can detect missile launches within seconds of ignition, providing European defenders with maximum warning time. For a ballistic missile launched from Western Russia targeting Paris, ODIN’S EYE would provide practically half an hour of advanced warning and nearly as much time as it would take for the missile to actually fly. This could be enough time to activate missile defenses, alert civilian populations, and most likely launch retaliatory strikes. Note that since France and the UK have their own stocks of nuclear missiles, both sequestered in submarines or aircraft and ready to be deployed, their own reserves are unlikely to be targeted as part of a first strike by Russia. This deterrent is arguably what makes ODIN’S EYE so important. Russia's ability to target the US has been rapidly diminished with layered detection systems that could detect attacks within minutes and prompt a counterstrike from the US. Given that the US has roughly the same number of nuclear warheads, about 1,700 deployed as of 2025, its own strike would be devastating. However, if Russia starts with an attack on Europe, a detection by the US system might come a bit too late to structure a meaningful counterattack from land-based forces. With France and the UK able to detect a launch almost as soon as it happens and launch missiles from the sea far away from their population centers, Russia, or any other European opponent at the time, now has to think twice about making offensive moves. The Constellation's ability to track hypersonic weapons is equally significant. Russia has invested heavily in hypersonic missiles like the Kinzhal and Avangard, specifically because they can defeat traditional radar-based early warning systems through their speed and maneuverability. But space-based infrared sensors track these weapons throughout their entire flight trajectory, nullifying the speed advantage and providing more accurate detection. The development timeline for ODIN’S EYE reveals the urgency behind European strategic planning. The first ODIN’S EYE project began in July 2021, with the EU providing only several million euros in funding to a consortium of 34 companies from 12 countries for initial studies, requirement definitions, and architecture trade-offs over 24 months. Then ODIN’S EYE 2 was launched in December 2023 as a 36-month project with 90 million euros, or $105 million, of EU funding, focusing on the definition, development, integration, and verification of the entire mission and system simulator. This phase represents the critical transition from concept studies to actual system development and testing. Based on typical space program development cycles and the stated timeline, ODIN’S EYE will likely achieve initial operational capability somewhere around 2027. This coincides perfectly with intelligence assessments suggesting that Russia could potentially attack NATO members between 2027 and 2029, meaning Europe's space-based shield will be operational just when it's most needed. OHB Hellas and Digital Connect are responsible for the ground segment, data analysis, and onboard processing, while the broader coalition includes European defense giants like Airbus, Ariane Group, Leonardo, and Thales. This distributed approach is responsible for the faster time frame compared to traditional military infrastructure and procurement, which can take several years. The shift from using a fully American-owned system to one that is based entirely in Europe, using European funding, resources, and technology giants, can have significant implications for transatlantic relations. For decades, Europe has depended on American early warning data, which created an asymmetric relationship where Europe contributed ground forces and financial resources to NATO while remaining dependent on American space assets for strategic warning. ODIN’S EYE eliminates this dependence, potentially allowing Europe to pursue independent strategic policies without concern for American approval. Tensions can always arise between European and American interests, with one of the most notable examples being the second term of President Donald Trump, which has created increased conflict between NATO members due to arguably erratic US policies and geopolitical posturing. If this results in a potential rift inside NATO that might degrade its cohesiveness or cause the US to leave the alliance entirely, Europe will no longer need to worry about losing access to critical missile warning data. For Russia, this development is catastrophic. Putin's nuclear intimidation strategy has been remarkably effective, precisely because European leaders never had complete confidence in their defensive capabilities. The constant threat of Russian nuclear escalation has constrained European support for Ukraine, limited NATO expansion, and influenced everything from energy policy to defense spending. With ODIN’S EYE operational, Russian nuclear threats lose much of their psychological impact. European leaders will have complete, real-time awareness of Russian missile activities, eliminating the uncertainty that makes nuclear blackmail effective. When Putin threatens to use tactical nuclear weapons, European monitoring will know immediately whether Russian forces are actually preparing for launch or merely posturing. The ODIN’S EYE early warning system will also provide an architecture that can more easily be integrated with other systems, including broader NATO systems. This allows Europe to maintain a modicum of control over its aerial and space defenses, while also giving it the ability to bolster its alliance with the US or Canada by sharing infrastructure for more layered defenses. Rather than replacing NATO's missile warning systems entirely, ODIN’S EYE will augment them with European-controlled sensors that provide redundancy and enhanced coverage. In peacetime, data from European satellites will be shared with NATO's Missile Defense Command structure, improving overall alliance defensive capabilities. But in crises where Europe and American interests might diverge, Europe retains independent access to critical missile warning data. This flexibility could prove essential if future American administrations pursue isolationist policies or demand European compliance with controversial American strategic decisions. The system also enhances European contributions to NATO's Article 5 collective defense commitments. Previously, European allies depended heavily on American space assets to detect threats against NATO territory. With ODIN’S EYE operational, Europe can be the first responder if Russia decides to strike and the one to mount the first countermeasure. The deployment of ODIN’S EYE forces Russia into an increasingly difficult strategic position. Putin's nuclear intimidation strategy relies on uncertainty, as European leaders must constantly wonder whether Russian threats are genuine or merely psychological pressure. Russian military doctrine also emphasizes strategic deception and the element of surprise in nuclear operations. ODIN’S EYE makes all of this impossible. European satellites will track any Russian missile preparation activities, launch procedures, and trajectory adjustments, eliminating Russia's ability to conduct surprise attacks or maintain strategic ambiguity, with their proximity to Russia allowing for practically real-time updates on nuclear warhead movements. This transparency also complicates Russian conventional military operations. The same sensors that track ballistic missiles can monitor for conventional missile launches, providing European intelligence with unprecedented insight into Russian military activities. This will make it much more difficult for Russia to conduct operations like the Ukraine invasion without extensive warning. The psychological impact extends beyond military considerations. Russian leaders have grown accustomed to operating in the shadows, using uncertainty and fear to achieve political objectives. ODIN’S EYE strips away this advantage, forcing Russia to operate under constant European surveillance. ODIN’S EYE represents just the beginning of European space-based defense capabilities. In recent years, the European Union has embarked on a push to enhance its space-based surveillance abilities, including the Ariane Group-led Sauron project for space situational awareness, and the Vitrocazette-led Integral project for exchanging sensitive operational data. These programs combine to create a comprehensive European space defense architecture that extends far beyond missile warning. Some of their future capabilities will likely include space-based interceptors and advanced electronic warfare systems designed to protect European space assets. And the industrial base supporting all these programs continues to expand. European companies are investing heavily in space manufacturing, advanced sensors, and satellite technologies with dual-use military applications. This creates a virtuous cycle where commercial space development supports military capabilities, while defense contracts fund technological advancement. Plus, with Russia's aggression practically proven, European economic giants like Germany have approved much higher loan limits to boost military spending. As ODIN’S EYE moves toward operational deployment between 2027 and 2029, Europe will fundamentally alter the strategic balance of power that has dominated the continent since the end of the Cold War. For the first time in generations, European leaders will possess complete, independent awareness of missile threats targeting their territory. Of course, ODIN’S EYE is just part of the equation, and the prospect of nuclear war is unlikely to be completely removed with just one system. To learn more about how one war could practically destroy the Earth as we know it, and why early warning and deterrence matters, watch our video on what can happen in a nuclear war. And to stay informed on the latest developments in defense technology and geopolitics, subscribe to The Military Show for daily videos. And thank you for watching.